future generations will not and should not forgive those who ignore this moment, no matter their reasoning. Future generations will judge our effort not just as a policy failure, but as a massive collective moral failure of historic consequence.
As Secretary of State John Kerry flies into Lima to give an impassioned speech about combating climate change, he says nothing about the proposed Keystone XL tar sands pipeline. Protesters gathered near Kerry's speech to send a message against the pipeline. At least they tried to. Global warming. We're broadcasting from Peru, which is the first time a COP, the Conference of Parties, this UN climate summit in 20 years, has been held in the heart of Amazon country. Well, on Thursday, I spoke to the man who crunched the numbers on the Keystone XL job creation, has raised a lot of questions about.
My name is Sean Sweeney. I co-direct Cornell University's Global Labor Institute, and I'm also here representing trade unions for energy democracy.
So I just tried to ask Secretary Kerry about Keystone XL. He didn't answer the question. Vice President Gore did. He's opposed. I asked Todd Stern, the chief U.S. climate negotiator. He wouldn't answer the question. You've been involved at a high level when it comes to Keystone XL and providing the numbers for President Obama around it. Is that right?
That's correct, yes, the job figures.
What have you found?
Well, the jobs debate has been severely distorted by TransCanada Corporation and the American Petroleum Institute. They put forward numbers that really cannot stand up to serious scrutiny based on normal research practices and methodologies. The numbers are far, far higher than actually real. The numbers submitted to the State Department were far, far lower, and this is borne out with the State Department's environmental impact statement.
Democracy Now! also spoke to Bruce Hamilton, who is the vice president of Amalgamated Transit Union.
The ATU is here to express the point of view that there is an alternative point of view in U.S. labor, and it's a point of view that really supports a real deal on climate that is enforceable and that actually reduces emissions.
What's your position on the Keystone XL?
The ATU was the first union to oppose the Keystone XL pipeline back in 2011. And since then, some other unions have joined us, which is very good. The National Nurses Union, TWU, somewhat the CWA, and SEIU, a lot of locals, 1199, and a lot of other unions have come into the fight against further expansion of dirty oil.
And why?
Well, the primary reason is to save humanity on the planet. We also believe that labor has a responsibility to really lead the transition to a low carbon, to really a no carbon economy. Because if we don't do that, then some kind of a transition is going to be made by big business, and it is going to be very detrimental to working people and poor people. Far, far, far more jobs are available in fighting against climate change than there ever could possibly be in expanding dirty fuel. As a matter of fact, the biggest job killer really is inaction on climate change.
So I asked Secretary Kerry about his position on Keystone XL. He wouldn't answer. Are you concerned about which way the Obama administration will go?
Yes, I'm concerned. It would just be a lot of climate scientists say it really would be the end of the game if Keystone gets built, because it would mean a vast expansion of the tar sands in Alberta that would be brought to for export out of the southern United States. And apart from all of the dangers involved to farmers in Kansas and others, there's just a huge danger of putting more carbon in the atmosphere. We just can't be doing that.
What's about the one?
Steel Pulse here on Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman. We're broadcasting from the U.S. Climate Change Conference here in Lima, Peru.